Physicists have discovered yet another form of matter, excitonium. The new discovery has all of these scientists very ecstatic. If Julian was here, the pun would have made you unsubscribe. You're welcome. Excitonium is pretty exciting because this is a discovery 50 years in the making. That's when excitonium was first theorized. But proving it existed has been a bit tricky because it looked remarkably like another kind of electron movement called a Perel's phase. Basically, it's about how the electrons move around a nucleus, but don't get too electrified. Let's back up a second. Thanks to new measurement techniques, excitonium's existence has been conclusively demonstrated. So now that we know it exists, what exactly is it? Excitonium is a condensate. It's a collection of particles that exhibit quantum phenomena like superconductivity or superfluidity, but on a macroscopic scale. The particles that make up excitonium are naturally called excitons. Excitons are bosons, the category of particles that includes such hits as the photon, the gluon, and of course the Higgs boson. Now, tilt your head back, because here comes the part that's gonna make your brain melt and dribble out your nose a bit. Excitons are a composite particle. Composite particles are something that are made up of two or more elementary particles. But with excitons, it's not actually that simple. They're made up of the electron that has jumped to a higher energy level from the crowded outermost shell of an atom, and the hole that the electron left behind. Yeah. The other electrons in that crowded shell make that hole behave as if it were a particle with a positive charge, and the hole attracts the escaped electron back like it's coaxing a runaway dog home with a treat. When the two are reunited, that forms an exciton. If an electron combining with the empty space that it left behind to make a new particle makes perfect sense to you, then congratulations on your future as a particle physicist. For the rest of us, it's one more example of how the quantum world is as intuitive as Windows 8. But don't fret, even physicists aren't totally sure what excitonium will actually do. Before it was discovered, it was argued that it would act like a superfluid, or a perfect conductor, or an insulator. Now that we've finally found it, we can figure out which argument was right, and what it could actually be used for. If particle physics excites you, then please subscribe for more videos like this one on quantum teleportation. And if that doesn't excite you, maybe this will. Seeker Plus is coming back, finally, I know! Come join me and some guests as we deep dive into conversations about science subjects that we love the most. Subscribe so you don't miss it, and thanks for watching Seeker.